Hi friends, in this video I am going to tell about the Veep software and advantages, limitations and how to get installed that software with free license. The details I am going to see. Already I just explained in that first session Veep's how it works. So first I am going to create the hydrologic model and have to assign a data and then physical and operational constraints of the system. After that we should run the model with our required simulation conditions for different scenarios, and we can interpret the results with scenario comparison in Veep itself. Finally, our topmost objective is to get the project feasibility and the solutions for the existing problem. That will be analyzed through the Veep. And also this one also I explained the basics. The system, what is the hydrologic system means? The natural system with a basin, and also the hydraulic structure which are present in that system, that would be modeled. And also operation and the supply demand, that relation should be modeled in the Veep. This is one of the typical model already done. Here the one watershed boundary delineated, and what are the water bodies are there, and whichever we want to consider in our model, that would be modeled. And relations between the streams, the anywhere you have any man-made channels and diversions, that would be modeled in Veep. Every option is available. What are the physical constraints and the operational constraints can be presented by the model. And then capabilities and limitations. Major capabilities is inbuilt topographic and climate data. The Princeton server itself have the climate data about 1948 to 2010. In this say gridded data, rainfall data from satellite captured radar data, that would be used. We can also add our own observed data, and then we can calibrate within Veep itself how the data is valid with the observed one. And also we can modify, we can add additional years in that inbuilt one. And next is runtime of simulations is very less. For any 20-30 years simulation also, it will take only less time to give the results, because there are the two solvers, the linear one and the XA solver. And the XA solver is especially used for the big analysis with the short times, and the very excellent graphical user interface, which is very useful to interact with the software. And then to scenario analysis solvers are there. And the main thing is it interfaces with the groundwater models, Modflow and Qual2K. It is very very useful to relate the whole system, the surface water and the groundwater relations. And also it's a integrated one. And the calibration facilities are there. Wherever you're getting results for any stream or any point, you're getting results from the software, that should be calibrated with the observed one. Here the option is there. We can enter the observed values in separate column, and then we check and calibrate the model within that Veep environment itself. And also it's open source for students and non-government organizations who are working for no benefit, no cost benefit. Also we can use our organization or institution mail ID to get the free license. And it has continuously taking updates, so many updates are there. So it's on a dynamically improving software. So in upcoming days so many facilities will be added, I think. And the current limitations of the software is, for taking any inbuilt data, the dem data, inbuilt dem data is only 90 meter resolution, That is not fair for a small watershed analysis. That will be give a strange water boundaries, watershed boundaries. So it is our choice to take. If you take any big watershed, that will be almost give an exact boundary. For minor watersheds, even in between the watershed, any road embankment came, that watershed boundary will be changed fully. So it is 90 meter dam is not good for the small watersheds. So we can avoid, or we can correct the model based on a precise dam. If you have any boundary shape files, we can import in WIP model, and then based on that background watershed boundary, we can modify the model. And the model is only for man 3 time series. So for historical analysis is a very good to run any 40 years, 30 years data for a monthly time series, but we can not use a daily time series or hourly time series to get the peak floods. In that, we can go for a other open source softwares like HMS and ECRAS. Okay, and also inbuilt climate data available only up to 2010. I already told 1948 to 2010 only available. Also, for current analysis, we have to add the climate data manually. Here I mentioned the points already told. I have to modify the watershed boundaries based on the on-field observations, and also we have to modify the drainage system based on observation. Wherever the man-made channels have, that won't follow the exact topographic elevation. Maybe diversions have and curtain covers or underground tunnels, anything additionally added in that system manually, that should be modified in the model manually. And the diversion percentage, wherever the sluices or controlled weirs, flood regulators have in the system, you have to mention how much percentage of water is diverting and how much for flow is retained and diverted. That should be added manually. And also already told that climate data could be added from 2010 to whatever till now, that should be added. And what are the major outputs we can get from the WIP for water accounting? The overall system, we can get a yield at every tanks, wherever every tanks or every sub water sub watershed unit, we can delineate and get the exact yield in that particular catchment area. And also any river point, what is the flow, and any confluence point, any project location, wherever you want get a yield, we can assign a point, computation point, and we can get the result. And we can compare the supply and demand and get the unmet demand. And also supply, how much supply is delivered to the particular demand, that should be not. I just showing only major outputs, plenty of outputs, whatever we want to, related to the watershed and the water source analysis, we can get. Here I just highlighting the few things only. And also tank storage levels based on the time series, how much it's a simple mass balance conditions that we can get, and the runoff from individual catchments, and a comparison of results. That would be a important thing in the WIP model, the comparisons and the calibrations and the scenario creations and the comparison between the scenarios and the future analysis. That are the important advantages in the WIP. There I just mentioned the interpretations. What are the interpretation needed to account the water system? The tank system reliability and resiliency. So totally you can get the yield, flow, and whatever the hydraulic and hydrologic components. Based on that, you can tell the overall system is reliable or and how much time it take to get back the normal positions or resilience. That should be interpreted based on that results. And the surplus and drought units of the system, so you have the subunits of the basin, subunits or sub watersheds, and which units are in vulnerable positions which get frequent surplus or frequent drop, that should be separately we can predict. And the behavior of the system with respect to different events, if you take any 30 to 40 years of data and we can analyze what are the surplus years and what are the drought years and how many cycle drought and surplus cycles are present, how many years the system takes to get the surplus and the drought, that should be analyzed very clearly. And now I tell how to install the software for only new users. And there's also just Google it, Weep Water Evolution and Planning. And the weep21.org, the official website, the software. Here we have to do login. The new users should be sign in with the basic detail. Otherwise join the Weep. Oh, okay. I think I used the wrong one. Just give login. For new users, join the Weep forum. Just click. I already have a account, but I used the wrong password. Here you have to give the details. Here only considerable thing is, main thing is, you have to give the official mail ID or institutional mail ID. If you are a student, you have to give a institutional mail ID. Otherwise, you are any government official, non-profit organization, you have to give your organizational or institute mail ID here, or official mail ID. And then we have to apply the license here using Weep. We can use the download option to get the software. Once you log in, you can get the download option, and then the license option is there. In that license, you have to enter the details what you are doing with Weep, like that you have to enter. They mail the license details with the mail based on your request. This is only 1 year free license they tell you at initial. After 1 year, we can renew that license by again request for renewal. Now I logged in with my account details. Once you logged in, you can directly download the Weep here. The current version is 2021.0, and then you are going to apply for the license. Mail, go to the licensing option. I already have the license. Otherwise, if you don't have, you have to fill the reason what you are doing, for research purpose or study purpose, that should be mentioned. And then request will be sent, and that reply will come within 2-3 days. Then no issues on others. Okay, these are the languages available here. In other sessions, I explained about the how to work with Weep model for water accounting. Thank you.